And do you know where he was going that day?
To the church.
He was going to church.
No, don't get me wrong. I mean, that place had been abandoned for almost a year. But he was looking for his brother.
At the church?
Yeah, there'd been reports of, pretty brutal firefight up there. He'd heard his brother might have been caught up in it.
Sure, but... And I'm not quite clear on this. Was his brother still alive?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't think he knew either. Seems like he was on his way to find out.
So, his brother, he was in the army?
Yes and no. It's complicated. You gotta remember it was pretty chaotic back then.
Of course. Okay, let's back up a bit.
Sure.
What complicated the situation?
Just the history of it all. His brother had been a recruit in the Altus Armed Forces, boot camp, basic training, you know? Well, this is back when NATO was still keeping the peace. But after U.S. forces pulled out, apparently he deserted.
Do you know why?
No, just... I know they argued a lot about it.
Was he upset that his brother had deserted?
Oh, no, he was no fan of the government. I mean, by that time, very few people were.
What, then?
I think he was just... I don't know. Sick of all the violence. Didn't want to see his brother get caught up in all that.
In what?
More bloodshed.
You say bloodshed. You mean with the guerrillas?
Our resident non-state actors. His brother had become dead set on joining the cause.
I see. And that brings us to the church. The firefight?
Yeah. U.S. forces were invading. The guerrillas were finally on the front foot. You can imagine the mess.
I've seen the pictures.
Right. It was more than just that, though. All those competing factions, people just disappear. And that kind of chaos.